When Fate Comes Knocking. Chapter 7. Her Pride. I don't drink with customers, Lauren replied calmly. Luna was irked after hearing that. Who do you think you are, refusing Mr. Langdon? Lauren didn't deign to respond and kept on doing her makeup. She had to go home after this last song. For Riley was alone at home. Even though she had a nanny, Lauren was still worried. The Imperial Court was a merry place once night fell. After doing her makeup, she went to perform writing S on the wall before trying to retire for the night. However, Lucy came to inform her about the VIP, Mr. Langdon, asking for her. Lauren refused. But once she came down, the drunken Mr. Langdon came and grabbed her hand. You should feel honored I want you. How dare you insult me? I am going to F**ck you tonight. So name your price. Because of her crippled hand, Lauren couldn't exert too much strength. So she struggled. But to no avail. Even so, she looked at Langdon defiantly. Mr. Langdon, I am a singer here, not a bar girl. If you d like, you can choose someone else. They'll satisfy you. Mr. Langdon was livid. Don't f**king put yourself on a pedestal. UB**TCH. You ray just a slut. So know your place. All you do is sleep around. He dragged her away and mumbled. Refuse me one more time and I'll f**ck you right here. Lauren was scared. She was no longer the same woman she was 5 years ago. So she knew how to read the room. Mr. Langdon pinned her against the cold, hard wall before trying to tear her dress apart. When Lauren felt what he was doing, she quickly chomped down on his hand and tasted something metallic. UB**TCH. How dare you bite me? You wanna die? Mr. Langdon slapped her. Though it felt like a sledgehammer for Lauren, she started seeing stars, and blood trickled from her mouth. Even so, she sneered, and her eyes were dead. The commotion attracted the guards and manager. The latter quickly apologized. Mr. Langdon, Mary is strictly a singer. I'll get you the best ladies we have tonight. And it's all on the house. Shut the f**ck up. I don't need your money. I want her. And nothing else. Stop me if you dare. Mr. Langdon wasn't backing down now that he was injured. Left with no choice, the manager gave Lauren a look of sympathy. She looked up slowly, her face pale, her mouth bloodied. Even so, she smiled at Mr. Langdon. Mr. Langdon, I heard you got to where you are today thanks to your wife. Your company will be listed soon. So if something were to happen now, it might be bad for you. No, I am just a singer. And even though I thank you for your appreciation, there is no need for you to ruin your own future for me. Mr. Langdon's face contorted with rage. For Lauren hit him where it hurt most. At the same time, she clenched her fists and was drenched in cold sweat, standing rooted to the spot. Welcome to download Flipread app to read more chapters of When Fate Comes Knocking novel online.